Here is Israel.
So during Operation Cast Lead, when Artists for Israel came here to paint the bomb shelters in Sderot, I had a reporter come up to us, and everyone wants to make things political when it comes to Israel. And so he said to me, well, would you paint on the other side? And I said to him, sure. I said, but here's the problem. I have a homosexual artist with the group. I have two black artists. I have a Latino artist. I've got some Catholics who practice their faith. Can I bring them? You know, would that be acceptable? And they were, you know, we were told no. And that's something that I think really stuck with our artist. It was another point when we were trying to go into Bet Lechem, and there was a big sign that said, no Israelis. And I won't go into what the rest of the sign said. And so the Israelis who were traveling with us said, you guys go ahead, we'll meet you when you come out. And he said, absolutely not. At this point, they were crew. They were boys. And they're not gonna go where other people aren't gonna go. And it's that diversity here. It's that homosexual artist, woman, man, every age, every ethnicity. I don't even need to begin listing them because I'm bound to leave some group out. All together, all mixed up in a country creating. And that's the key word here, is that this is a country constantly on the cusp of creation. So anything else that's going on which is trying to prevent that is trying to prevent a new birth every day, a birth of art, a birth of a new idea, a birth of a new way of living, a new culture. And I think a lot of that really happens right here, which is completely out of the political realm, which is just here to provide artistic, you know, services and paint and everything you need. You come to this country and you're related at all to the graffiti scene, you're related at all to, I don't know, tattooing, or you look different than the majority of people in the rest of the world, and you automatically have a family here. I have people come here all the time and they don't mention my name, they don't know any of the artists who have been here, and they say, you know, they met here, they met some great friends, they went out, they ate dinner. And it's that unity, it's that diversity which is allowing for the creation. And for me, that's what continues to separate Israel. Especially when you see the arts in other countries where they're manipulated for political ends, where they're propaganda, where they're oppressed or shut down, if not propaganda. And here, that's never happening. When A4I started, it was said to us, well, why art? And then people started figuring out art, right? We talked about art being the new culture war about 6 months before Ethan Bronner wrote the same thing in the New York Times. So first it was why art, then it was why graffiti, and then it was why non-Jewish graffiti artists, and then it was why even do this? What does it matter? What does it mean, right? And every day we have a new idea for A4I, a new art form that has to be expressed, and we always get why. Any college kids listening to me, do it your way. The way of doing advocacy, the way of expressing your love and showing Israel, it's not going to be taught to you by your professors. It's not going to be taught to you by any of the on-campus organizations, any of the pre-existing stuff. That way, it's an old model. It's broken. What you're learning right today, the organization presenting this to you, and myself and Artists for Israel, we may not be right, but we're trying something new, and it's going to be more effective than what's been in the past. So the power is within you, the ability to make change, the ability to decide how you're going to promote Israel, or how you're just going to promote art and creation, which to me has its home here, that's on you. So Artists for Israel is one of the most, or the most, controversial nonprofits in the world. It also means we're the most recognized, and it means we're the most effective. So all I gotta say is do you.
Here is Israel.